What's going on, everybody? Jay Gleese here, and in this video, we're going to cover multiple ways to get pressure and open our opponent up in Dragon Ball FighterZ. Now, the biggest thing with Dragon Ball FighterZ is having a good neutral game. So you don't want to just, rush in with your super dash. All right, you want to make sure you're playing some type of neutral game and you wind up getting in on your opponent, hopefully in, somewhere in this position. A great way to cut down space is by using the instant air dash. And you basically use the same button as the super dash, right? We all know we can dash in the air, all right? See that? You can dash in the air. All right, but if we use the super dash button and jump in the air and hold forward, we're able to dash instantly. Alright, just so you can see that there. And that's the super dash button while holding forward in the air. Now, if you're not holding forward, you will get this. Alright, so make sure that you are holding forward. Now, this opens up quite a bit of things as far as attacking your opponent. So, as you air dash in instantly, the angle that you're at, you're able to hit them with two overheads or go with an overhead low. And the way that works is just using your light attack. So as I jump in, you'll see I have him set the guard, but you'll see that I'll hit him with two hits in the air. Oh, that time it was one. So yeah, it was two hits in the air. All right, so you're able to go in with double overhead, or like I did the first time, you can go in with an overhead low. Remember, all air attacks are overheads. Her first attack and her standing one or standing light attack is a low. All right, now if your character doesn't have a, standing light that's a low, typically the crouching light will be a low, or you can use the crouching medium. All right, so it would look like that, but you would go into a full combo. So we're gonna set him off a block, and I'm gonna show you what a combo would look like with this type of setup. All right, now the next thing we're going to talk about is using our assists to extend pressure. All right, so we have Vegeta out there shooting projectiles. All right, we have Hit coming in, just kicking him so I can extend pressure. It puts my opponent in block stun. So with that extra block stun, we're able to stay plus, meaning that we're going to recover before our opponent, and I'm going to be able to continue hitting buttons. Alright, so you can just continue your pressure that way. You can also use the instant air dash and dash over him, possibly, and mix him up that way. So then you get like a cross-up thing going for you. There's a lot of things you can do with the block stun here. You can stagger. You can do something like this too, which we'll get to in a little bit. Dragon Rush as he's holding block because he knows you're plus. And then you can go into a full combo that way. Alright, so there's a lot of stuff that you can do as far as, extending block pressure. And now we're going to talk about mix-ups. So we can do things like this. So we can go with our light attacks and then cancel into our forward medium. Alright, and that goes into an overhead. Alright, we can also go with lights into the crouching medium. Alright, and that goes into a low. Now, to make this pressure extend, all right, particularly if the overhead hits, like if we're going to go with the overhead, we're going to call the assist in, and when the overhead hits, depending on the character that you have, you may be able to do this, you may not, but you can extend the combo into full damage if the overhead hits, and it basically puts them in a 50-50, though the low comes out before the overhead, but your opponent will most likely be respecting the low, and if you have an assist that can come out and you can time it properly with the overhead to hit when the assist comes out, you can launch them into a full combo. So this is what it looks like. Alright, so you notice that the overhead hit at the same time as my assist and it popped him up in the air. Now, you don't have to use the characters that I use. These are all basic principles that you can utilize with almost any team in the game, as long as you have some type of assist that's going to allow you to do that. We can also do it with Vegeta. His timing's a little bit different, though. And we can end it any way that we would like to. And next, we're going to take a look at the low variation. And there we go. Now, one thing that I want you to keep in mind here is the fact that there's positives and negatives to going in with our lights first. So the positive is that I can hit confirm a lot easier, meaning that I'm putting attacks out there and I'm able to see if the low hits and if the first couple hits do make contact, and it allows me to go into combos and go into things with the knowledge of whether or not my opponent is blocking or they got hit. So that's basically what a hit confirm is. Now, by adding these two hits, the slight penalty, I guess you can say, for, you know, making it more hit confirmable is that the damage scales more. So if I do the exact same combo and eliminate the first two attacks, you'll see it does a lot more damage. All right, so I guess you can say that's a slight penalty, but against someone that is blocking, look how much damage that does. But against someone that's blocking a lot, you're typically going to want to utilize your hit confirming, all right? A lot of times you're going to want to do that. It's very, very seldom that you're just going to dash up and low into the launch, you know? It's a difficult task to do. You can try to keep it safe, you know, in certain ways. Certain characters have special moves. So, like, let's do this. All right, now we're getting a little bit deeper than I wanted to get, but we're gonna do it. All right, so let's say, like, the character has something safe, and I notice I'm good enough that I can hit confirm the low medium into the standing medium, and like, oh, they're blocking, right? Boop, let me go into that. All right, so now I'm safe. All right, so this is a lot harder of a hit confirm to land. But just know that if you are able to master this and then notice that they're blocking and go into something safe, you're going to be way better off because it doesn't scale as much if it does hit. So that's just something to keep in mind. But there is nothing wrong going in with the full combo here. All right, and making sure that you're staying safe. All right, so definitely keep that in mind. Safety is always something you want to worry about in a fighting game, and you want to take as minimal risk, you know, as you can while still yielding damage. So just keep that in mind and just something to think about as you move forward. On wake up, and when I say wake up, we're talking about wake up on the ground. All right, you have two options going in. All right, so you can attack an opponent when they're on the ground, or what I like to do is Dragon Rush sometimes. Now remember, the Dragon Rush is like a throw, so they can't block the Dragon Rush. So a lot of times this is like a type of setup that I'll do. So we get the hard knockdown and I'll go into my super. This one's gonna go into a hard knockdown as well. So I'll run up or dash up, attack, and then go right into Dragon Rush. Now why do I want to attack? I'm purposely whiffing the attack. All right, I'm whiffing it on purpose because I want him to see that I'm hitting buttons. So when I dash up like that and I hit a button, all right, it's going to most likely going to cause him to block. So if he goes to block, this is going to be great. And I'm just going to open him up. All right, then we get another combo. All right, we're in there. And again, like I said, all of these are principles that you can use with, you know, any type of team. It doesn't have to be these three characters. It can be any team in the game. As long as you have a character that's able to extend combos off of the overhead and do some of the little things that we're doing. And a lot of characters can do that. So definitely lab your characters up and kind of gather an understanding as to how you can extend combos with the characters that you use. So there you go. Those are three awesome ways to open up your opponent. Three things that I do very often when playing. It's like the whole basis of my pressure game. And there you go. All right, so that's it. As always, thanks for checking in. If you have a comment or a question, leave it down in the comment section, and I'll be sure to address it as soon as possible. So as always, thanks for checking in. It's Jay Glee signing out, and continue to game strong.